Now to an eyewitness to the attack on the Metro, Zoya Sheftalovich. And Zoya, I understand that you ran towards the Metro when you heard about the explosion. What did you see?
I saw a scene of probably around about a dozen to 15 people who had been carried out of the Metro and who were lying outside the Metro entrance on Rue de la Loire, which is the main street that cuts through Brussels in the European Quarter. The actual station itself, Malbec, it's just a few hundred meters from the main scene of EU activity, the European Commission and the European Council. It's around about 200 meters away from my office. So I was already basically there when I heard that there had been attacks at Malbec, and I was running towards it to see what was going on.
And a scene of chaos, and you were able to see the wounded and casualties being taken. Tell us more about this neighborhood. What is around this neighborhood?
Around Malbec, it's really just the heart of the European Quarter. The European Commission and Council are nearby, very close, within a few hundred meters. It's up from the Schuman metro station, which is the main metro station for the European Quarter. It's also very close to the European Parliament. It's probably around about a 5 to 7 minute walk to the European Parliament. Those are the three main EU institutions in Brussels. It's also very close to the Arc Loire area. That's where, for example, the U.S. Embassy is based. Also, the Russian Embassy is around there. There are several embassies in that Arc Loire area. And that's one stop in the opposite direction from Malbec, from Schuman. So this is really the heart of the EU Quarter, but also the international quarter in Brussels.
Okay, Zoya Sheftalovich, thanks very much for that report.
And we're going to turn now, George, to the Brussels police spokesman, Christian Deconinck. He joins us on the phone now with the latest on the security situation there now. And Mr. Deconinck, I know that you're most familiar right now with what happened in the Metro station. What is the latest that you could tell us, sir?
Well, the information that I could gather is the fact that we had an explosion in the Metro station called Malbec. There are several casualties. We have several people deceased, several people injured, but I don't have exact figures about the casualties yet now. Rapidly, fire department, medical service and police were deployed on the scene. There is a large security perimeter installed now so that all those services can work on the scene.
And the airport as well, and what exactly are the services doing there right now, the police force doing right now at this hour?
Well, for the police forces, we have the task to protect the medical services working there and also to prevent people from entering the security perimeter so that there is no danger for the medical service and the fire department to work.
And sir, there was no indication about an imminent attack of any sort?
Well, normally terrorist attack, they don't prevent or they don't say on the forehand that they will commit an attack, of course.
And the heightened alert that you are under now, can you tell us what precautions are being taken?
Well, all public transport is shut down in Brussels. There are no buses, no trams, no metro, and the train stations are also closed in Brussels. And the people are asked to remain inside so that we, the police, and the security forces can work on the scenes.
All right, Mr. Deconinck, thank you. And please know our thoughts are with everyone that is there. Thank you very much for joining us.
Okay, Robin, thanks.